Hi, my name is Jim McIntosh, and I'm the Chief Financial Officer for the Clark County School District. The Advisory Committee for Assembly Bill 394, which is the reorganization of the Clark County School District, had requested the Clark County School District provide a presentation on the equity of funding distribution within the Clark County School District. Part of the presentation requires us to define for the committee what is equity. And one of the things that we have to make very clear when we talk about equity within a school district is we are not talking about adequacy. Adequacy is how much money it takes to run or fully fund a school district. What we're talking about here is equity. How do we properly distribute funds in order that those students who require additional funds receive what they need? So there are two types of equity that we deal with in the Clark County School District or any school district. There's horizontal equity, and that's treating similar students similarly or providing similar funding for similar students. And there's vertical equity, or providing dissimilar students with dissimilar funding. These graphics show some hypothetical examples of classrooms and the funding provided to the students within each classroom. Let's talk about horizontal equity first. Horizontal equity could be ensuring that your school district provides a similar amount of funds for a similar group of people, and that could be a broad group of students, such as we ensure that all first graders at elementary schools receive the same amount of funding, or we ensure that all students in career and technical programs receive the same amount of funding. Now let's talk about vertical equity. Vertical equity is ensuring that dissimilar students receive dissimilar funding. And what do we mean by that? Well, there are certain students in the Clark County School District that require more resources in order for us to get them to these common educational outcomes. Those outcomes are things such as math, science, reading proficiency, graduation, all of the things that we'd like for our students to achieve in the school year. Certain students will require additional resources, though, to get there. And we want to ensure that they are provided those resources. So I want to make one distinction here. Equity is not equality. Equality is treating everybody exactly the same. Equity is ensuring dissimilar students get exactly what they need. So when a student is a special education student, when a student's first language is not English, when a student comes from an at-risk background, these students we've found, studies have found, that require additional resources in order to educate. And we need to ensure that the funding distribution model within the Clark County School District addresses those needs and that those students receive the additional funding that they need in order to reach those common educational outcomes. If we take horizontal equity and we take vertical equity and we combine the two together, what are we looking for? Equity in the school district equals educational opportunity for all of our students and providing for those common educational outcomes for every one of the students in the Clark County School District. Equity is providing students what they need and not just access to equal funding. So how does the Clark County School District go about doing this? Well, the first thing we have to do is we have to separate the different streams of revenue that the Clark County School District receives. One of the largest that it receives is from the state through the Nevada Plan. The Nevada Plan is a funding formula that was created in 1967 to appropriately fund school districts across the state of Nevada. The money that the district receives from the Nevada Plan and some additional revenues that it receives outside of this plan generally go into what's known as the general fund of the Clark County School District. This is the largest fund in the Clark County School District, and it is, for the most part, is the funding used to appropriate for the day-to-day operations of running a school district, paying teacher salaries, paying for instructional materials, paying for utilities. Those funds are what we call non-categorical, meaning that we have to use the funds for the mission of the Clark County School District, but the Clark County School District has a lot of discretion in how those funds are spent. Outside of the general fund, the district also receives supplementary funds, either from the state or the federal government. Those funds are for programs such as class size reduction, special education. Federal programs provide money, or what we call categorical funds, for students at risk, which are known as Title I funds, and for special education funds, also known as an IDEA grant. Certain state grants we receive include funding for full day kindergarten, our Zoom schools, which are our special schools that we use to teach our students where English is not their first language. We also have Victory schools to address the needs of our at-risk students or students who come from a background of poverty. In addition to that, the school district also receives funds for a program known as Read by Three, and that's Read by Grade Three. And it's a program that the state recently instituted in the last legislative session in order to ensure that our students are reading and are literate by grade three. With all of these programs, we have to understand exactly how the funding is distributed within the Clark County School District. In the general fund, the largest fund of the district, the funding we generally receive through the distributive school account and the Nevada plan, those funding formulas are based off of what we call staff or student-based funding formulas. So revenues aren't driven directly to a school. Staffing models are driven to a school. Schools require a certain level of staffing in order to operate. There are a certain number of core teachers that are required to be at those schools teaching core subjects to operate the school. And so what we do is in the general fund is we provide a staffing model to a school, not revenues per se, but a staffing model, and we allow for what we call full-time equivalent employees to be hired by the school. That's different when it comes to state grants and federal grants. Many times state grants and federal grants are appropriated to a school through a revenue process that is based off of a key metric or some proprietary formula based on need or some other criteria. For example, our Title I funds that we receive from the federal government are generally distributed to schools based off of the percentage of students that qualify for a free or reduced lunch. Our IDEA funds from the federal government are generally based off of the type of disability that the student has. When it comes to state grants, there are proprietary formulas for Victory Schools, for Zoom Schools, and for our Read by Three programs. Studies have shown that funding allocations to schools within a single school district may have a greater impact on students than funding across school districts. And this is why the concept of equitable distributions of funds is so important. So that concludes the presentation on equity. Thank you for your time. For more information, please go to the Clark County School District's website at www.ccsd.net or www.ccsd.net/openbook. Thank you.